everybody. I'm Dio Synodinos, president of C4 Media, creators of InfoQ and QCon, and I'm delighted to be here with Frank Greco, a member of the QCon programming committee, to talk about QCon Plus November. Frank, what has been your experience with QCon over the years?
Well, I've certainly been involved with some of the program committees over the past, you know, six years now. And we've had excellent experience with some of the speakers, with all the speakers. I mean, the thing with QCon is that it's practitioner-based. And you leave QCon, the last day of QCon, you come up with a laundry list of things that you want to try, right? When you get back to the office and talk to your colleagues, says, we should try this. And also, there are things that you learn, since it's an early adopter audience, you learn what not to try, which is just as valuable as things to try. So it's these are great conferences. And being that they're targeting senior architects, senior developers, it's nice to be in that crowd and you have people that are all at the same level. It's not so much focused on the 101 type of people, but I mean, certainly that's important, but that's not what QCon's all about.
Frank, having been part of the programming committee discussions this year, is there any topic or any track that stands out for you personally?
Well, there's so many cool tracks. I mean, every year there's really, really cool tracks. I mean, certainly since I'm Java-centric, the Java track is pretty exciting. There's a lot of cool in-depth Java talks. The machine learning track is something that I've been focused on machine learning for the past few years. I mean, besides my Java hat, I wear the machine learning hat, just to come up with a standard for machine learning in Java. There's many interesting talks about putting machine learning into production. And as I said before, like there are things that you learn that work and certain things that may not work. And I'm looking forward to some of the speakers in the machine learning track and some of the best practices and what did work and what did not work.
Thank you very much.